sounds a bit loud. Be fine. Be fine. Options. Yeah, that's all still good. Load. The resolution's just fucked. But we knew that already. Postmother Rosario would probably be less suffering. That's impressive. I don't know what I just... Yeah, I remember breaking completely because Sherlock's, disguise. I am supposed to go be here. Why? That branch doesn't look like it's leaves in the wind. That looks like it's breathing at 15 frames a second. Mildly worrying. Yeah, there is... That is not a...
I must learn more about this abbey before I travel to the forest.
That's... encouraging. I clicked once and he's jogging at this point now.
Yes, my son?
I am sorry to disturb you, brother, but...
What the fuck are the textures on his hat? I've just noticed.
I have a matter of great importance which led me here, and I am certain that you may be of help. Well, I am looking for my brother. Not a brother like yourself, but rather my brother by birth.
That sounded like it should have been a prompted lie, but he didn't say anything.
Unlikely. You see, he has not always chosen the right path in life. I recently learned that he had had some troubles, and I have been frantic to find him. One of his acquaintances told me that my brother had spoken of Richmond's Abbey. My brother's name is James Little. Perhaps you know of him? If I ask you some questions, would it trouble you? It would at the least help me to learn whether he is here. He is unaware, but recently we received a small inheritance. I think if he were told of this, it would ease his mind and help him put these troubles behind him.
No acknowledgements or anything, just straight into the questions.
This forest is most impressive.
It is very large.
What the
if someone were to
was
hide
that
in
perspective
there, it
change?
It would be most difficult to find them.
That's not even foreshadowing. That's not even five shadowing. That's jumped straight to seven shadowing.
The Abbey produces a fine liquor, doesn't it?
Yes, we distill a liquor that contains medicinal herbs. It does allow us a small income, but it also can attract certain rascals. That's why we are mindful of inquisitive strangers.
Rascals.
Have there been any burglaries?
Oh, we do get the occasional tramp. They sometimes seek shelter in the old ruins that lie in the midst of the forest. They have been known to trespass into our sacred cloister, seeking some sustenance. At least, that is always their tale upon discovery. But it is only the liquor that goes missing.
Sally's bar. Liquor in the front, poker in the back.
Do you know the way to these ruins?
Many paths lead there. If you are prepared for a walk, you may take the path that lies 30 meters in that direction.
No one talks like that! No one talks like that! Also, I need to check something now. Come on, Google. Oh, that's fucking that. Yeah. So this is age set in 1897. The UK adopted the metric system in 1896. You're telling me that after less than a year of it being adapted, this monk is already telling me meters? Bullshit. Absolute bullshit. Then again, you know, saying the fact that when I found some money in this, it was a modern £10 note. Oh, wow.
Thank you very much, brother. I would not at all be surprised if my brother is discovered to be the architect of your recent thefts, as he may well be hiding within the forest ruins. Sadly, for some time now, he has suffered from an addiction to strong drink. Please, allow me to indemnify these losses on my brother's behalf. I am afraid it will have to come from his share of the inheritance. Goodbye.
Good luck, my brother.
Didn't seem sus at all. Never. No.
Not very engaging.
I'm sorry, Sherlock, what were you saying that about? What's not very engaging? Is it the rain? Is it the rain that has literally just started? I swear it was not raining before. I might be going insane, but I swear it was not raining. But what else are we not very engaged in? The conversation? Wouldn't you say that was, you know, just shortly after the fact? Because it doesn't matter if he's in earshot or not, you don't give a fuck who you're talking about, Holmes. Oh wait, shit, there's footsteps. Can I highlight any of these? Nope, I just look like I have to follow it. Oh, it's going to be one of those things, isn't it? Oh... And immediately I can't see the things. It's UK rain out of nowhere. There's usually at least some build-up. Not like Florida where it's just, you know, sunny 1 second, 5 seconds later, it's torrential. And I thought, you know, it's rained out of nowhere in England, but Jesus Christ, this place is a whole new level. And the place in the game is as well. Why do two transitions when I clicked once, and why have footprints at the beginning when I now have none? Game, were you trying to say with the footprints I need to follow them? And if so, can I have them, please? And Holmes is just walking into it. Okay. Holmes, you are too big for your surroundings again. Is this supposed to be a maze, or is it just giving me the illusion of a maze? Am I just going to be walking through a forest with nothing going on in full... Looks like a face. I mean, it's just some arranged leaves, but that looks like a face. I will say that I saw something.
It must be an indication, but why?
Arrow point that way. Well, there's been no others. Apart from near the footprints. There's only one path so far.
Again, there's no indications now. Why? I mean, what are you trying to communicate here? What can it be?
I mean, what can it be? Holmes, again, you are way too big for the surroundings. Okay, a path all the way up that way, but I can't... Oh my good god, where am I supposed to freaking go? It's... I love that the monk said that, you know, many paths lead to the forest ruins. But I'm pretty sure there's only going to be one. What the fuck even is this?
Is it near there?
Holmes, what does that even mean? Is it near where? Yes, yes, it means yes. Are you just for the drink command? Yes, I do. What the fuck? Do I have anything around, you know, to investigate or to look at or to tell me if I'm going in the right direction or not? What the fuck? Click three times just to get him to move, and he's growing like a giant.
I smell smoke.
I guess that means I'm getting close. Either that or we're about to get burned.
Quick, some water to douse this fire, else we lose precious evidence.
What the... Oh my god, immediate time thing. I was just thinking, Oh, great. I was just about thinking, hang on. There's, you know, I smell smoke. Thinking, maybe I'm going to get into a game over situation. I don't want to have to go through all that again. Holmes, why? I don't have anything on me. Where the fuck did you even come from? You're like Cotton Eye Joe. Can there be some form of urgency in what he's doing?
I can go no further.
This is awful. A time section in a labyrinth to try and find. I get why, but what the fuck? Okay, so those... Oh!
Quickly, I must find some water.
What even the fuck? Not the camera angles. Yeah, it's like these scene transitions. What the fuck? Yo, I'm clicking. For fuck's sake, this game.
Not clicking enough. We're in the right way.
Yeah, apparently not.
I can go no further.
Why did you let me walk all the way over there before you said that? What the fuck? I've almost lost this. This is awful. Sherlock moves with absolutely no urgency whatsoever. No, that's the entire way of just... I've already gone. I've gone into a big fucking circle. Sherlock, please. I swear I've been here as well.
Quickly, I must find some water.
Jesus Christ! Game's actually painful when it's like this. At this rate, I'm not going to be able to do it, simply because it's taken me this long to get to the river, the water source. That's the wrong way. Fuck! We're close, because that's where I found the bucket. Why? Christ alive, that was close.
My word, I can't see anything.
No room for mistakes. There was no room for anything there.
Ah, now I see better. I need something.
Room for one mistake, apparently, yeah.
This is ink. It is not English. And it's
can't retreat, redeem, can I? I need it.
3 days ago.
Sherlock, I saw you glitch up there.
Someone has slept here.
Brilliant deduction, Sherlock. I could not have gathered that a mattress has been slept on.
All these papers were gathered and burned. I need to find evidence somewhere else.
So, it was pointless then. It was pointless. That whole time situation the game over that it links to was pointless. Because that's the fire we just put out. And the fire has rendered the evidence useless, so why would losing the timer make it so that that's, you know, if you're not going to give me the evidence when I do the thing right, then don't punish me for doing it wrong. Oh, this is bad. Right, hello and welcome. How we get to the beginning of Dark Souls 1? This is worse than Dark Souls, in fairness wise.
A from the Richmond Abbey.
What? Oh. I'm sorry, but I had to go to a different screen just to be able to select that, so he goes back to the previous screen to look at it. Oh, this is so broken. This game is just something else on the scale of brokenness. Sure, Sherlock, just stand, gaze lovingly at the corner. Oh, I wonder.
Someone knelt here often. I'm curious. I need something. Ah, I was positive. It moves.
The knife opens everything.
Very interesting. These letters are faded and illegible.
But that particular one is not.
This ink is not made in England.
Letter from an alcoholic. I have always tried to avoid boredom in any possible way. First, it was just a few rounds with my fellows, then the alcohol all the time, all the time, all the... Read them hundreds of times. Enough, enough, enough. My story is worth as much as another story. I've got nothing to be ashamed of, nothing. I was ruined and misunderstood. This swine enjoyed success in his life because of my mother's money. But half of this money held by him must be given back to me according to all that is right. Absolutely, Your Honor, half. And I wasn't going to let myself so easily when you are so far away and when you dream. Owing to him, I would be able to never more this cursed foul continent. Shades of the Devil. I was told about it at school when I was quite small. Shades of the Devil. Yes, certainly, they are demons. They whisper sweet words into your ear. They listen to you and make promises to you. They say they will help you when you are down, but no. They help you to rise only so they can lead you to hell. They lifted me, one under each arm, but when I bade them cease in the midst of their prattle, I then heard the sound of their demon wings. Demons. Haven't done this on purpose, I swear. I'm sure he knew, but why? Why have money? It is certain, Your Honor, they...
These letters are faded and illegible. Someone knelt here often. I'm curious. Someone knelt here often. Someone knelt here often.
Right, long welcome. What the... This is just... What the fuck is any of this? You have... come here and managed to avoid the most frustrating timed puzzle I've ever seen in my entire friggin' life. Was that just it? Showing two. Yeah, so here's the thing. Got close to this area. Shark says, I smell smoke. Go a bit further on, and there is a fire, and he says, oh no, I have to get some water before we lose the evidence. So I then have to backtrack through a forest maze, pick up a bucket, take it to a pond, fill the bucket of water up, and take it back here in time, on a timed thing, to then use it on the fire to douse it out. And I failed this, saying I had a lack of evidence, so the evidence burned up. Fine, fair. But when I doused out the fire and then looked at the documents, he said, oh no, these are too badly burned. I'm going to find something else. So why was it a game over? I just don't even... I am beyond evening.
I need something.
Oh, there we are. Him? On the fuck, I know, right?
Size 10. I should leave this forest and join Watson at Sherringford Hall.
Are you going to change first, Sherlock? Or are you just going to go like that? That's a bit iffy that I can't just fast travel from here. Sherlock's going to get smacked. No? Why is it not letting me leave? As in fast travel leave. Oh, something's gonna happen, isn't it? We're gonna have to use the knife on someone. Just a little nip play. Oh, yeah, another thing, right. So, spoke to a monk who's, you know, at the abbey and asked him directions to the forest. And he said, 30 meters that way. Now, I'll tell you the problem with that. This game takes place less than 1 year after the UK adopted the metric system. Are you really telling me that a secluded monk is going to start immediately using meters for length, knowing exactly how far it is? Just no. Game, I clicked in the bottom right. You can see my cursor. It hasn't moved. Why has Sherlock ceased moving? Why is Sherlock getting stuck on the geometry in a point-and-click game where there is no geometry? Bruh, this is why I've got the wine. Hello, welcome, Phoenix. This is just... I don't know. Is that white wine? Sadly, yes, that's the only kind I have. Thank you, DJ, for a redeeming drink. There's no handsome armor in the forest, sadly. So if a suit of armor became sentient and you wanted to fuck it, would you be fucking it in the armor sea? I had to get a hard limit just to thaw those shenanigans. That would be my suggestion, yes. But also my bottle has a dick on it because it's local. But dick. Dick wine. Brain, no, why? Why the fuck? Oh, God, Brain, why? My brain immediately went to, what sort of grapes you have to stand on to, get dick wine? I was like, well, of course, testicles. Brain, why?
I mean, why not?
And now I can go to Baker
Let
Street.
Let us return to Sherringford Hall.
Well, at least he did change. Okay, I'm glad they actually put in the thing, you go back to Baker Street, change, and then go. And literally, that's all you do, is you change out of that god-awful outfit. Oh, God, I...
Oh, Dr. Watson, beg pardon for imposing on you.
No, this is what my brain's like.
I must get a message to Inspector Lestrade, and...
He is just inside, and I am sure Lestrade. That he would be most eager to assist you.
No, it would be better if he would hear this from you rather than myself. The present situation requires me to be elsewhere. Please be
good enough for a random quote and gets the bald man bangs the woods.
That I renounce any rights to the succession. Also, I will not be at my offices. I would not wish him to waste time looking for me there. Goodbye, and I thank you for your kind assistance, Dr. Watson.
Detain him. Watson? Oh my God, he's levitating! Lestrade has ascended.
I was upstairs and I could have sworn I just saw that blasted scoundrel Grimble through the window.
Yes, you are right. But you have no chance of catching him now. He has run away as if the very devil himself were after him.
It is not the devil that's after him, but myself. He would fare better if it were the devil on his trail.
He gave me a message for you, Lestrade.
He said he renounces any rights to the succession.
Thank you, Kelly, for your contribution to the Laugh Game Challenge.
What do you say? This is astonishing news. This will not prevent me from finding him. I want to know how it so happens that a dead man is found in a building to which only Grimble is known to possess the keys. By the way, where is our great detective? Oh, here he comes now.
Hello, gentlemen. What were you discussing?
Grimble has renounced all possible rights to the succession of Bromsby Enterprises.
But that does nothing to alter the fact that he is the ideal guilty party. Sir Bromsby had very important news that he intended to announce on the day of his death. What if this surprise news was the ouster of Grimble and Bromsby's intent to name his own daughter to succeed him? Do you think something otherwise, Holmes?
No, it is nothing. May I ask you a question, Lestrade? Would it be possible to keep this new information about Grimble?
I don't even know anymore. What the fuck even was that?
But I presume that you must have your reasons. I will do my best to keep this information private till the day after tomorrow.
Thank you, Lestrade. By the way, I would like to speak with Miss Bromsby. Where can I find her?
I do believe she's with her faithful knight in her sitting room. This gentleman never, so to speak, leaves her side. If this story spares them any further pain, no doubt they will soon be renowned as the most beautiful couple in London.
Why is Sherlock gesticulating when he's not talking?
But my heart feels heavy that I may have been an instrument of their sorrow.
By the way, my brother Mycroft has answered one of my letters, and his information seems to be most interesting. You can look at it if you would like. I have had a copy made for you.
Give me some... I don't know what the fuck any of that was. I really don't. What the fuck? Aldasa Abyss. Dear Sherlock, with time of the essence, here is the information I managed to gather. W&G Company was founded by Joseph Grimble and his partner Raymond Waters. The majority of the capital was provided by Waters, who was the son of a wealthy shipowner. When J. Grimble died in 1886, his shares passed according to his will to his partner, Mr. Waters. The business of the Caladasa Abyss is one that we, as British people, are loath to remember. In the entire history of colonization, we have played falsely with the image we claim for ourselves. The truth of this murky business is still protected by the military authorities, so I possess but a small portion of the facts in this matter. Because of the Caladasa Abyss, the supply convoys of the garrisons from the northeast of Bombay had to make long detours. Well, they actually captured Mycroft's personality in writing, at least. His cousin Minecraft. I must have misheard that. Mycroft, but Minecraft works. Oh my god. Been some crafty side draft. Nice. A decision was reached to construct a bridge over the abyss. The construction was entrusted to a contractor who enjoyed strong support within the military echelons, a Mr. Melvin Bromsby. Bromsby committed to perform this task in a time frame that many specialists considered extremely ambitious given the difficulties associated with its location and other practicalities. The abyss was situated in the middle of a jungle located in a distant and isolated place. A battalion was assigned to assure the security of the construction efforts that would take several months. One of the officers from this battalion was Captain Lowry. From the beginning, nothing went right with the project. They talk of how poor the soil proved to be and the recurring accidents. The remains from ritual sacrifices were found at the bottom of the abyss, which caused fear in the superstitious Hindu workers. There was also the presence of a man-eating tiger nearby and other exotic mysteries. Thus, in the next few weeks, the construction suffered considerable delays. At the start of the second month, the officers in charge of the battalion asked to be retained in their role of supervision, regardless of their personal hardships with the assignment. The command in Bombay supported their request, as it was a great opportunity to economize on the costs of construction, which were considerable. Then the officers asked for men from the nearby villages and the towns to strengthen the teams on site. The soldiers following the convoys complained that large barriers barred their view of the site and prevented assessment of its progress. They were also denied passage beyond the enclosures. They further noted that although they brought workers to the site, how long is this? Workers to the site, they never had escorted any from the police and back to their homes. They were also deeply concerned that they could not identify the source of an unbearably foul stench that surrounded the worksite. Some people claim they have fallen ill merely from breathing the smoke from some invisible fire that came from the impenetrable mound. I think that says that we're going to have to name this vod Minecraft's Unimpenetrable Mound. In fact, I'm going to do that right now before I get distracted. Oh, good God. Minecraft's Impenetrable Mound. Read the entire encyclopedia this way. Yeah, right. Construction was eventually completed on or near schedule, but an inconceivable number of Indian families still do not know what happened to their husband, father, son, or brother. They left one day to build this bridge, never to be seen or heard from again. One of the officers, Captain Lowry, tried to reveal the truth that everyone preferred to be left unknown. He was abandoned by his superiors and his comrades. He wanted to leave Bombay and applied for the post of principal at a penitentiary in Italy. It occurs frequently with non-commissioned officers, as there is no better director than a former officer of the British Army. But he's a captain. Captains aren't non-commissioned officers. What the fuck? A former officer of the British Army. Everyone knows it is an envious because of it. But the army refused to grant him leave. They threatened him with charges of desertion if he left the Indian territory. They must have been afraid that one day he would reach England and find attentive ears for a story which he must not be told. He died ill and alone, and here is a strange request for a soldier of the British Army. He asked to be cremated in the Indian manner. This last request was in fact refused by the army. All of his property was bequeathed to the military orphanage Brahmi in Bombay. In hopes that this information shall prove helpful, good luck, Mycroft. A 5-page letter!
What million things to write?
I mean, it's Mycroft, it makes sense. Alright, well, let's go and transcend gravity.
I hear laughter coming from the powder room.
Oh no. There's a man in the ladies' room. Why do I not hear anything now? Because I caught them in the air. What the fuck?
Good afternoon, Mr. Holmes. James has just been showing me the photographs from his hunts.
Oh, but I wasn't the only hunter.
My respects, Miss Bromsby. Hello, Lieutenant. If I could have a look.
I'm sorry, what? Sherlock has just walked in on this couple, no idea what on earth they're doing, and he says, Lieutenant, may I have a look? And my conversation option is nice peace. What the fuck? Nice peace, is that why he's standing cock-legged? I'm gonna see where this goes.
I must say, this is quite a handsome specimen, but it is surprising how light it appears.
That bull weighed near 1,000 stones.
No, beg pardon. I was referring to your portfolio.
That is but another
3 rounds of forced laughter. What the fuck?
I came here specifically to inform you that everything goes well with the case, Miss Bromsby. But I need to ask you a question of a more personal nature. If the Lieutenant would be so gallant as to give us a moment of privacy.
Your servant, Mr. Holmes. I will retire to the smoking room.
With your nice piece. Black dots on the wall move. Oh, God. Well, they didn't actually continue the conversation. She's just now looking at me dead. Well, that's going to be the,
I should reveal one of my hints. Does this photograph belong to you?
Yes, it's mine. This is the photo of an actress who was with a touring London company. They gave a performance at the town near my boarding school in Switzerland.
Plantagen just broke me. I don't blame you. What the fuck?
She was kind enough to meet with us in her dressing room after the show.
I love how photo is now a greyed out conversation topic.
And how would you describe this actress?
Oh, she was fascinating, on the stage and in life as well. She personally inscribed this likeness for me. You see, they were available for purchase during the intermission. She was so very beautiful.
Pray, continue.
When I met with her, she showed me this beautiful earring that she wore. It was in the shape of a wave with foam, made entirely of sparkling stones. It's strange, but I have never talked about this with anyone till now. I do hope I see you again someday.
Perhaps. Now, listen to me, my dear child. I must ask you to speak to no one about our conversation, not under any circumstances. The discovery of the truth rests on your silence. I've got to go now.
I understand.
What? What was the purpose of any of that? Sherlock, why are you walking a lot faster than Watson?
Want to get away from him.
Why did you have them stop and then scene transition? What?
This lieutenant seems a very commendable person. Miss Lavinia is fortunate to have him near.
Welcome back, DJ.
Lestrade was saying that he has found more evidence of Grimble's trail. The corpse we found at the cement factory may well have been an accomplice and the true murderer of Sir Bromsby. Grimble could have easily obtained an invitation for him to the reception. Then, some time after the deed was done, Grimble eliminated his accomplice to prevent his speaking. Or perhaps not. Yeah, whatever are you musing about, Holmes? Holmes?
What is it, Watson?
Blasted Holmes! You haven't heard a word that I have said.
It is of no consequence. Tell me, have you had the opportunity to redeem the item with the receipt we found at Hunter's?
Oh, yes. It was a simple matter. In order
Why
to get
is Sherlock in the door?
Hunter agreed to redeem the item within 2 days' time. Look, these appear to be real diamonds.
Hmm. It seems to me that we have gathered all of the key elements, Watson. However, before we retire, let's summarise our findings.
What the fuck?
The questions should be answered yes or no and justified by the evidence or testimony received during the investigation.
5 questions, okay. Was the leader of the thugs who attacked Holmes directly connected to the case?
What?
Can we say the person who killed Simon Hunter is skilled with weapons? Are the ruins near Richmond Abbey a common haunt for wanderers? Yes. That we know from talking to brother. To the his name's just Brother. What the hell just happened? I don't know, like. It's been pretty much the entire day, was just going to the Abbey and then that. Can the handwriting on the message found on the ruins be the same as that as on a previous document? I'm sorry, are they seriously asking me to do a handwriting analysis? I mean, it almost sounds like yes. Well, so the answer to that has to be yes, and one of the pieces of evidence has to be not that one. Less of an alcoholic. Is it easy for a retired English officer to find a work as a prisoner abroad? Yes. They are actually wanting me to do handwriting analysis. Tempted to say that the other one is actually one of the threats. Fuck it. Oh, right, okay, this is gonna be it. I put for the heart of this one shot and first glance the pictures for carrying weapons and lead on to kill them probably nothing you might not know. One shot through the heart with small caliber weapon. I would say that, you know, denotes some form of skill with weapons, yes. So this has got a document, Wong J. Known in certain undesirable districts. So I don't think, no, I don't think it was directly connected.
We must have made an error, Watson. Let's check our answers.
Oh my god. I'm gonna skip ahead and I'm going to just get a guide now and see what I'm missing. Because what the fuck? No, that is definitely not. That is the wrong Sherlock. Right, yeah, we're on day 4. Okay, day 4. Right, day 4 quiz.
The question should be answered.
Yes, I know, Holmes. The question 1, was the leader of thugs who attacked Holmes directly the case? Yes. Okay. Question 2, can we say yes? Appleby, yep, got that right. Are the ruins a common haunt for wanderers? Yes. Obsession with the monk, or brother. And how am I writing on the message? Yes. This episode, oh, right, okay. Is it easy? Yes.
It is simplicity itself, Watson. We have answered all the questions.
What the fuck, Lestrade? He was walking through the carriage.
Hello, Watson.
Good morning, Lestrade. You are an early riser.
Watson, why are your legs through the chair?
Good morning, Lestrade. You look really tired. You must have had a
Lestrade, why are you through the chair?
How on earth could you know that, Holmes?
I can read you like an open book.
I
jest with you, gentlemen.
It's not the proper time for
jesting. Sherlock's leg is through the table,
but
leg.
But upon my word, how did you find out about the minister? I was assured that only 3 or 4 persons at most had knowledge of this meeting.
Oh, I would rather withhold my explanation.
So you must be aware of the subject of the meeting.
Indeed, but Dr. Watson knows nothing of these events.
Lestrade's left knee is clipping with the floor somehow.
They have decided that it would be most imprudent, given the crisis we're under, for a young lady, barely 18 years of age, to take control over one of the country's 3 biggest building enterprises.
I begin to understand, but...
According to the minister, despite his bad habits due to the lack of consideration for his partner, Grimble is the only individual that the council has faith in to reverse the current state of the Bromsby Holdings. It was further explained to me that if there is a choice to make in the direction of my investigation, and lacking any new evidence to the contrary, I must take these concerns into account.
This is outrageous.
And you, Lestrade, what are your personal thoughts on the matter?
I really can't say, Holmes. The prospect offered by Grimble seems so attractive. He had credible motive to murder Bromsby and then foul it. In addition, he was the only individual with apparent access to the shed at the cement factory where we discovered the corpse of his presumed accomplice. However, the only gadfly to this theory is his statement to Dr. Watson when he clearly renounced all rights of succession.
That is an item of singular curiosity.
It is difficult for me to believe that a man who could plan and execute 2 or 3 murders with such
cool presence
of mind...
Why does Watson keep looking like he's a child who just got told no to the eating from the cookie jar?
I also have spent sufficient time at Sherringford Hall to have a high opinion of Lieutenant Harrington.
I agree with you. This young man, by all accounts, has an unimpeachable character.
I have no evidence to cast doubt on the truthfulness of his testimony. We reconstructed the crime, and it was evident from where he stood he could easily see Miss Bromsby despite the crowd. Really, Holmes, I'm not a man who would hand over an innocent girl to the executioner, even should it cost me my career.
I am pleased to hear you say this, Lestrade. By the way, Lestrade, have you any knowledge of the...
Just crossed his legs and they went through each other.
Is it that shabby theatre that lies near the bank of the Thames?
Yes. Several weeks ago, it was acquired by the Fairfax Theatre Company. Their international tour...
Also, Sherlock is not fully sitting on that chair.
...as they are set to open their new play in a week.
Hello and welcome. Have a chair at Apollon to become of the virtue.
You mean the author of the threatening letter that we found on Bromsby's desk?
No more, no less.
I must admit, I thought the letter to be of small consequence.
One shall
After
be the number of curiosities, and the number
Sometimes
of curiosities shall be one.
Are the most painful. In fact, we are leaving for Aston's right now. I know that you are quite busy, but if you feel like joining us, meet us at noon.
Why? Vagrancy and... Promigacy?
This might be interesting.
Profligacy? I don't even know what the fuck that is. This triumphant tour of 3 continents, Fairfax Theatre Company is pleased to present the exclusive world premiere of Vagrancy and Profligacy. Best Prescott with Carolyn Small and Riley Wilcox. Staged by the author, company director Dwight Richards. Sure. Really, Watson, you need to learn to stand gayer, because that is beyond straight.
Aston's Theatre. Here we are.
Reckless extravagance or wastefulness in the use of resources. Sensuous to sleep behavior. Sounds very much like a Google response.
We are not open to the public.
What the fuck is that face?
My soul. I can hardly believe my eyes. It is the young Sherlock Holmes, isn't it?
Watson, allow me to present Philotomy Kirby, who in his day was one of the last great hosts of the popular stage.
Why does he have a square on his forehead differently coloured from the rest of him? Why? What the fuck?
so he can still prattle away. Don't listen to him. This is the most talented student I've ever met, upon my word, as an actor. But those days are past. So, am I speaking to the former actor or the world-renowned detective today?
This face looks scarier than any horror game I've ever seen. Yeah, and the fact that she's levitating in the background. What the fuck? And he's just standing there with a glazed over look in his eyes while he's holding his dick. I don't even know.
Tell me, what you know about the Fairfax Theatre Troupe?
2 months ago, they returned from an international tour. Richards, their director, had managed to secure the necessary funds to buy back Aston's. It seems he had finally resolved his troubles.
Bigger goes for a random quote and gets, you could say I'm dealing with four King Hell. Ah. That sounds like, I'm pretty sure that's Dark Souls. When I was fighting the four kings. And having, apparently very little difficulty against something. We go, sorry, not. Phoenix goes for a random quote, and yes, I could get it up if you wanted. You say it isn't already up, always.
He was in some kind of trouble.
Oh, bah. It's always the same with those tours abroad.
Does it encourage me to drink, Callie?
Actress marries an Emir. Another time, the entire troupe has their luggage stolen. Anything is possible. Whatever occurs is usually nothing good. But who would have imagined such a tragedy?
What tragedy?
Their last tour started about 3 years ago. At that time, the troupe was housed at the Fairfax Theatre. But a series of failures forced the owners to sell it at a substantial loss.
Well, it's making me feel like it's from another game. Yeah, the proportions of him compared to everyone else just doesn't... It's not... It's wrong.
Miss Davenport,
the hands are too big, the forearms are too thin, and the face is just all over the place. It's too wished and stretched.
A young actor, costumier, makeup man called Jeffries. They decided, after the sale, to launch an international tour in order to raise funds.
Their success was assured?
Yes. The fame of English theatre is worldwide.
He also looks to be dressed in something that's a bit too modern for this era.
Developed a close relationship, which was much to the regret of the hot-headed Richards. He is a gypsy.
Also, I'm very certain a balcony seating area like that is not needed for a small theatre like this.
Pray continue.
In short, a dark tragedy occurred in a village in Latin America, located not far from...
I'm very certain the king wouldn't be coming
one
here.
One evening, after their performance, someone noticed...
You can tell it's not a king, you're a royally visited place. There's shit on the walls.
Local authorities were notified, and the alarm was raised.
He's made from a different game. Maybe. I mean... So Frogwares have issues with how they make the games, but they never have issues with the writing. Well, this game excluded some certain points. But there's clearly been work put into both the background and the models. It's just there was no conversation between who made the backgrounds and who made the models. So the Thomas Tank Engine game from Leapfrog. Denver saw that. Things go for random quoting, yes, I was swallowing my humbug, Mal. That was his excuse, yeah.
And Richards?
Richards was implicated in
what
some...
What's ping on Discord?
...seems to me. However, there was no proof of his involvement, and no bodies were ever found.
Oh yeah, because that's the only incriminating thing.
If you need more details...
What the fuck was that voice acting like? What a strange case!
As you may observe, they are rarely able to hold their tongues.
What don't you mean? I leapfrog learning system. Sounds like it was way after my time. I'm always nice. I haven't had those taste before sweets in years. I've never had them. I've never been enticed by them.
See you later, Kirby.
Yes. It was good seeing you again.
What is the mess that is his legs with all the furniture? My grand space around Christmas. Well, this original was the only thing he could.
I can't enter like that.
You can't enter like that. Go and sit on your throne.
Hello, young man. What are you looking at?
Oh, I'm sorry. You startled me.
Off the screen. So why is Watson right there, and where is Sherlock asking from?
You must be here to interview her.
Banner 94, yeah, that was after my time.
And Miss Caroline will surely shine. If only my father could have seen this day.
Your father?
Yes, I am Bruce Aston, and my father was Clyde Aston, the former owner of the theatre. It may have fallen into some disrepair, but during its time, it was well-loved by so many. A host of young actors debuted on that venerated stage. Why, it was at this very spot where Mr.
Did he just pronounce that debuted? Did he seriously just pronounce the word debuted as debuted? What the fuck? Fuck, debited. Also, why is one of his hands like seven shades darker than the other? What's going mad? No, it's if you are, then it's collective. They say a debut is debut too. It's debut, because it's a French word. Nice speaker, but he sounds like he's got the proper thing. The thing is, no one corrected him. They heard him say that, and they used it anyway. Could they not get it back for a re-record? Could they not say, hey, by the way, it's pronounced debuted? I know you wanted to make your international debut, but it's time for you to get D-Butt out of here. Yeet! And you faints for the drink.
Have you ever heard of the Fairfax Theatre?
It is the theatre which was demolished. It seems to me that it had been owned by Mr. Richards together with Miss Davenport and a friend of theirs. They left on an extended tour, but I think it went badly for them. After his return, Mr. Richards bought the theatre back from the bank, and I do hope his good fortune will continue.
Well, we can hope.
With the talented Miss Caroline...
Watson spoke, Sherlock was gesticulating.
And the building is still solid and comfortable. Though the bank took over the theatre, they left the keys...
What's that affirmation for Kipper?
From time to
Kipper,
time,
at least when I throw you at a wall, you collide, unlike the characters in this. Also, it reminds me of, like... another really, really awful, janky point-and-click adventure, Mystery of the Druids. Like, the main character is voiced by someone who's very clearly English. And he mispronounces pizza as pizza. And, like, it's the only flub in the entire thing. It's like, why? Why are you insisting on him having called it pizza? And why this guy say debited? No idea.
Are you a part of the troupe?
Yes. When Mr. Richards noticed how I had worked to keep the place up, he hired me.
Well, yeah, I don't know. It's not even just in one line. It's like, you know, what, if you look at one of the pizza boxes, it says, no pizza left in here. And it's like, okay, maybe that's just a one-off. But no, you look at another one, it says, Al's Pizza Palace makes the best pizza in London. It's like, what the fuck? Why is that one thing mispronounced? Although in fairness, apparently also in that game, they cannot decide between calling them druids or druids. Other details of psychic damage to me. Oh god, that's like, I don't know. I just don't know. Can I say debut the bubble? At least I don't say pizza's pizza, I say pizza. Yeah. As do most people when they see the word, like, how would you even think it's pronounced pizza? What pronunciation out there is pizza?
Goodbye, young man.
Goodbye, sir.
Time to play that game on Steam out. You say that, but I'm fairly certain I own it. I'm actually fairly certain I own Mystery of the Druids. Someone that struggles with pronouncing things often, I can see it. Like, yeah, sure, I fully get that you look at a word that you've never heard said aloud, and when you pronounce it, you pronounce how you think it looks, like how it should be said. That I get. But to be put into a game where other people are hearing these audio lines before it goes, you know, before it gets distributed, why did no one pick that up? Like, are you telling me that everyone who listened to the debited line and also the pizza lines, they listened to it, was like, yep, yeah, fine, cool, go, run with it. Possibly, but at the same time, what the fuck?
Excuse me, may I ask you some questions?
Naturally, I'm listening to you.
What the fuck is with his eyes? I love the fact that he said, naturally, I'm listening to you, and then proceeds to look away from me. As someone that works in FQA by design. Some EA justification bollocks. That dude took too many tries, eh? Or better yet, won't fix. Yeah, can't replicate, won't fix. That man has had one too many of something. Yeah, I think that something is facial polygons.
You are rehearsing at the moment, aren't you?
Yes, we are in rehearsal for the play we are to perform at the month end. Are you critics or reporters? As you know, we just came back from an extended tour. We were a triumph everywhere we performed.
He left an opening for an answer to his question and then just continued. Bethesda are unreproducible. Oh no, Bethesda is just as bad, because, you know, otherwise they'd actually fix those bugs. But no, they just rely on the player base to fix them, because they don't know how to code.
Tell us about this international tour.
We performed in France, in Switzerland, and even for an Arab prince. We were met with acclaim at every stop. If tragedy had not occurred, we were to appear next in New York. But fate had other plans for us.
Cowboy, what's this tragedy?
What sort of tragedy?
Oh, surely you must have heard about it. All because of those in our company who assume the right to reveal every distasteful and intimate detail of a most tragic event. Anything to gain publicity for themselves. It is positively scandalous. But even a professional actor such as myself respects the privileges of the press and the public's right to know.
Your sensitivity honors you.
Please, continue your story.
The events took place in a most horrid place in Brazil named Guacamole or Babiamo or something like that. I still can't stop asking myself what we were doing there in the first place. But to be brief,
in a most sordid place in Brazil named Guacamole, what the fuck?
With the beautiful Miss Davenport. Unfortunately, she was still very much the mistress of our director, Mr. Richards. I tell you, the tension was unbearable.
Really?
I can't.
In the view of a professional,
I fucking
they
can't.
Were the worst hours of my life.
Oh,
Miss Davenport was spending the whole day closeted in her room. Mr. Jeffries trembled so uncontrollably that he was unable to do our makeup. Mr. Richards stepped in, and I must say, he was a pitiful substitute. May you never be so ill-fortuned as to have your face in his large, hairy hands.
I'm sorry, I was too busy breaking from the guacamole comment. I missed most of his dialogue. But then, may you never have the misfortune to have your face in his large, hairy hands. What the fuck kind of dialogue is that? How is this game real? I don't even know. I just don't. Why is guacamole a dialogue option? Why? What the fuck?
And then?
Our first performance in that town was naturally...
And my response is, and then?
That very night, a tragedy took place. Mr. Jeffries and Miss Davenport went missing not long after the performance ended. It was impossible to find them. Then, we heard that Mr. Richards was arrested on suspicion of murder regarding Miss Davenport and Mr. Jeffries. We were outraged and most indignant. Some entertained thoughts that we would never leave that godforsaken place.
How was the matter resolved?
Fortunately for Mr. Richards and all of us, the prison warden and local chief of police was an Englishman. Lacking direct evidence or even a corpse, the accusations against Mr. Richards could not stand. He was set free on the spot. I think that had it not been for the intervention of that young expatriate, we might have been stranded in that Amazonian swamp for all eternity.
I agree, Ride. I really agree.
Well, thank you for your assistance.
That's all right. Don't hesitate
buffering.
To seek my help.
Don't listen to that milk toast. He gets positively weak in the knees over...
That is not how you spell
a
milk toast.
A policeman is just a policeman. That's it. If Richards isn't in jail, it's only because he had nothing to do there.
It's not how you spell milk toast. Oh my god.
We were talking about the tragedy which occurred during your previous tour, and...
You aren't the press, are you? No. In my opinion, you seem more like policemen. Well, listen closely, Inspectors. Miss Davenport was nothing more than an aging woman who adored seeing all the men at her feet.
What? Don't you mean...
She toyed with both Richards and Jeffries.
You taste
like
the drink.
Puppets. Dwight Richards is quick-tempered, but he wouldn't harm a hair on her head. And if you are eager to be so helpful, please, find my red-haired wig.
Must be getting too tired again. No, I just heard milk toast, right? No, that's exactly what was said. Milk toast. It's just... It's an actual word, but it's spelled M-I-L-Q-U-E, toast. It is pronounced milk toast, but you don't spell it like milk toast.
Oh my god.
I'm starting to wish they hadn't remade Sherlock Holmes The Awakened, because I want to play that next, because that's apparently also just as janky.
We must continue our investigation.
Of course.
Why are they now hovering up on the stage? Why is she floating? I don't even know. I just don't even know anymore. What the fuck? You know, I thought that the blank expression of Lavinia was going to be the thumbnail, but no, this has to be. That's the thumbnail for this. Holmes, why are you walking?
Hello, miss. I'm sorry for disturbing you.
Oh, you are welcome.
I'm sorry for disturbing you, and she responds with, you are welcome.
Welcome to disturb me.
I don't think that's what's meant to be said.
Isn't she nervous?
I don't even know. Why is she holding the lines book like that? A large ball of cube wall pen and chance. Ooh. Just came one word. Why? I just don't know. I really don't. And you know what the funny thing is? On my other monitor over here, which, because of the resolution buggering up, all my windows have been shoved to one side. Got a background picture of one of my screenshots from the Medium, and it just looks so fitting because the main character is just like looking off bemused somewhat. I'm pretty sure even she doesn't want to deal with this stuff.
Are you rehearsing the new play?
Yes, we are hard at work. Excuse me, did I just hear Mr. Kirby calling you Holmes? Is it really possible that you were the great detective, Sherlock Holmes, and you were Dr. Watson?
Also, what the fuck's with her expression? Like, what the fuck? That is the expression of someone who is watching the aforementioned Mr. Kirby bend over naked and spread his arse cheeks. That is the face of someone who stared into the abyss and it winked. What has she seen? What has happened to her? What the fuck?
I'm investigating the facts of the terrible events that occurred during the company's last tour.
Oh, I see. You were interested in that.
Why is she... why is she not blinking, but she just blinked.
Tell us about Miss Davenport.
She was fabulous and positively mesmerized men. She confessed to me that she had been indiscreet with our costumier, Jeffries. She had left Richards before, but she always came back to him. She said he understood her completely without her even saying a word.
Until that last time.
Forgive an admiring expert, but your earring is absolutely magnificent.
He's seen the thoughts of Papa.
Oh, that was a gift from Veronica. She got it along with two other matching earrings and small jewel case.
Once you see the thoughts of the Papas, you assume that face, just eternally.
Veronica insisted on cleansing it herself weekly with a special cleanser. It was remarkable and kept the earring all sparkling like stars. When I saw her last, Veronica...
The inscript was in Russian, translated to English, and the next were told read word for word. It would be Ukrainian, not Russian. We go goes for a random quote with, what do we say in times like this? And the quote comes back as, no, gonna get the fuck out of here. Yep. I have no idea what that was from, but very accurate.
Where can we find Doris?
She must be in her dressing room.
Goodbye, miss, and thanks.
You're welcome, Mr. Holmes.
It's such a mixed bag. Sometimes you will have a seemingly meaningless conversation prompt, and they will go on for ages, or you will have one which seems quite meaningful, and they will just say a short sentence. What the fuck? Can I go in here now? Yes. What the fuck has happened here? I don't even know how to describe how janky that is. She's alive. She's breathing. Clipping. I think that's beyond clipping. Claws, what happened here? A sword's gone places and a sword should ever go. I think that stool misread its job description. Wow. Oh, now it's time for me to go and feed the cats. You know what? I'm just gonna leave this here. Everyone's gonna get to revel in how cursed this is. I'll be right back. What the fuck? I've been away for a couple of minutes and it still astounds me. Is the sound the lady's making supposed to be snoring? Yes. She's supposed to be asleep. Give me 2 seconds, I've just got to take my meds. Quick thing. Usually this is what I'm doing when it's behind the scenes. Anything I can get whilst I'm not having to deal with why is that like that? That's not how hats hat. That's just no. Okay, so I've got 2 doors leading out of here. She's not even on the chair there.
Working people.
Oh, good God!
were a common thoroughfare. Nothing strange about that. They still haven't bothered to change the locks. Anyone can enter at will and abuse me. Me, who in the 50s, I'm not the good action. Did you see me with the best? Me! And they just treat me,
No matter what angle I'm looking at her from, she is still clipping through the chair. That's the big problem. Usually, when you look at a different perspective, it looks fine. No, there is no perspective by which that she looks fine on that chair. Kill it with fire, yes.
Are you rehearsing?
Why?
Everyone has his own technique. Cheers!
Why was the Watson angle the most cursed, but at the same time not cursed?
Miss Small told you about your earring. Would you mind showing it to us?
It can't be sold. Do you think that actors have no heart?
She told you about your earring. She told us about your earring.
My best friend, Veronica, who I love like my own daughter, she gave it to me. My little Veronica. She... Veronica.
They took the time to write bo-ho-ho. They actually wrote in the subtitles for her crying. Not so in brackets, sounds of crying or she cries or anything like that. It's bo-ho-ho. What the fuck? What the fuck? King of Flamer. Brother, get the Flamer. The heavy Flamer.
Do you know what has happened to your friend?
Now she's nowhere near.
She left with that Jeffreys. Oh, I know what they say. That Richard's murdered them both. Why not? He did everything for them. Everything. She was naught but a common flower girl. And that Jeffreys was a mere servant. Made them actors. Yes.
That same actors. Right, same.
Yes.
I'll have to get the ship mounted flamer. So her voice line trailed off into her snoring again. So basically she falls asleep deeply between every conversation line, but her mouth was still moving as if she was saying something, but there was just the snoring noise. What the fuck?
Oh, we'd better leave you to your rehearb.
Out! I need to concentrate.
That was a voice direction. It didn't need a subtitle for Hicks. What the fuck? Oh, this place is bigger than I thought.
Let's see whether we can find other evidence.
I wanted to go back so that I could go in the other door, but apparently no.
What chaos.
Watson? How much OCD do you have to describe this as chaos? Also, Watson, why are you bigger than the door? Sherlock, why are you going to have a head-on collision with the chandelier? Why is that a reclining seat that's got too much on the seat front? Whoever designed this room had no sense of perspective. I mean, why am I in control of Watson now? Why has my perspective suddenly shifted to Watson just for this room?
Through the flying dragons of the Virgin Islands, the land of gargantuan man-eating crabs, love in the heart of the Black Desert.
This author seems to be particularly inept.
I was just about to say they sound like Chuck Tingle titles. What?
a set of costumes. There are 30 listed.
I'm called Retribution Class Battleship. I think we just at this point need to get a Space Hulk through the warp and just crash it into the planet at this point.
But I count only 29. Yes, the artillery officer uniform is missing.
I'm sorry. Watson, you had a list of 30 costumes. Not only were you able to count, immediately count 29 in a half-open wardrobe, you also immediately noticed which one was missing. What the fuck? That's the sort of thing I could understand Sherlock doing, but you, Watson, no. That's not a Watson trait. And now, why am I back in control of Sherlock?
I feel like I forgot who you were supposed to be.
Why does that look like Jack Black? Thank you for the drink redeem, DJ. Again.
Who is it?
Mr. Richards, my name is Sherlock Holmes. You may put away your knife. Rest assured, I am indeed Sherlock Holmes. Thank you for receiving us, Mr. Richards.
Did they get a different voice actor to do those lines from Sherlock?
I will answer your questions, Mr. Holmes, only because I have heard about you.
Why does he sound like he's got a cold? Also, why is that door's texture unfinished? Jack Black is immortal and transcends time. Yeah. Which just reminds me of... Right, please tell me you've seen this, but there is a short YouTube video out there of Jack Black on, I think, the Jimmy Fallon show, and he's given a toy saxophone to play. But someone has done it as if he's a Monster Hunter Hunterhorn main. And as he's jamming and playing the thing, you're just seeing all these buffs coming off, and it's like, what the fuck? We don't need chaos on the planet, just Nova can. Yes, good. I am so glad you know the exact meme I'm talking about, because that is the first thing that comes into my head whenever someone says Jack Black. And I can't get it out of my head, especially as... Here, one of the members of Team Bondage, who we play Monster Hunter World with, was a hunting horn main, and every time he was hunting horning, he would throw that in the chat. We have a hunting horn main in your squad. Yeah, that's exactly it. Having tears for some of it, yeah. You're not seeing it pop in Discord for later. Literally, what Phoenix has just typed, put that into YouTube and you will find it. Because that's the title of the video, and it's just amazing. Now I also remember the animatic that people made for the Velcana release. It's like, oh yes, it's Velcana. Nope, you're fucked.
Would you tell me about Sir Bromsby?
I will not lie to you. I hated Bromsby. He is the cause of all my troubles, I swear.
Why is your jaw like that?
I often dreamed of killing Bromsby with my own two hands, but I didn't kill him.
From 4 years ago. God. I mean, I know that it went up around the time of Monster Hunter World. The door is properly textured there, but it's not on the outer, on the zoomed away view. What the fuck? Oh my god.
Do you know an Asian named Wong Jae?
What would he be doing there? Well, in the days of the Fairfax Theatre, I once employed a Chinese fellow who went by that name. However, I was forced to dismiss him because he was a great deal of trouble, and I've never
okay,
seen him
Okay, so he's about at shoulder height for Holmes and Watson from this perspective. Yeah, from the other perspective, he looks like he's around about the same height. And also, who the fuck told the voice actor to fake a French accent? Because that's awful.
You retain several keys.
See,
from
he looks
Fairfax
like he's around
theater,
about equal height there.
Well, I don't understand
down
the purpose
there again.
Of your questions, but yes, there were indeed two keys for the Fairfax Theatre main door. When the bank took possession, we gave only one of them to Blomsby's assistant. When asked, we lied and said there was only one key.
But why?
Well, we kept the other one out of spite. We had thoughts of returning in the night and wreaking havoc, but we had no opportunity as we left for abroad after the transfer to go on our tour. I suppose the key may have been lost somewhere along our travels.
Jace, if you're still listening, or, you know, if Q is listening as well, please let Q know that I've actually found something more offensive than their French. It's that guy.
About the disappearance of Miss Davenport.
I don't know why you want to talk about it. Does some vile curiosity cause you to
torment me
in this way?
I really need it. Though I will say, that's all the wine I've got left in that glass, and that's the last glass of the bottle. That is how much this game has driven me to drink in an hour and three quarters.
Thank you, Mr. Richards.
It is nothing, Mr. Holmes.
I should reveal one of my hints.
Oh, this can't be possible. How did you come by this? Dear God, if only someone like yourself had been present that evening.
Thank you both for your contributions to the One Game Student Challenge. What the actual fuck is this?
That night, after the performance, I left to stroll alone along the riverbank. The next morning, I had barely returned when I was seized by two local policemen and led to a prison cell for interrogation.
Why?
When I got there, an Englishman, the local chief of police, told me that a deserted boat had been discovered along the opposite bank of the river. Inside the boat, they found a star covered with blood. It belonged to Veronica, who had vanished, along with my other partner, Jeffreys.
And then what happened?
No one could prove my innocence, but they also found no proof of my complicity in these events, nor had they found any bodies.
Tell us a little more about your partners.
I had met Jeffreys while on tour. He was just a young tramp drunkard. Whatever my feelings were then, I feel no pity for him now. He betrayed me. But it wasn't the same with Veronica. I fear the pain caused by these events will forever haunt me.
Thank you, Mr. Richards.
It is nothing, Mr. Holmes.
This man is a wonderful actor.
Maybe, Watson. Maybe.
He couldn't act his way into a French class, though.
We are in the backstage area.
Ask you a few questions.
It all depends on what you're asking.
What the fuck is he? I've seen less unsettling things playing Call of Cthulhu.
What are you doing?
My job, my lord. I'm making this jumble look a bit neater.
Could you tell me what happened in Brazil?
Yes, my lord, I was there when it happened. But Mr. Richards takes it very personally to chat about those times. And I won't risk my position without some consideration, if you get my meaning.
Oh, no. 5 guineas.
Here's 5 guineas. How's that?
Oh, my lord, you're too kind. I don't really know much of what happened. You see,
like
I was alone at a tavern that
night,
and I was, as one could say,
Michael doesn't
want
to feel
so with
that precious. When
I returned to our lodgings,
getting
I
the fuck
the
out of her.
And the costumier had taken to their heels.
And what did you do then?
I made my way to the inn with all haste to learn what they'd taken in their sudden departure. You must understand my position. I was solely responsible for the security of the luggage and troop properties. Can you then imagine my surprise when I saw that nothing was missing? Absolutely nothing. They hadn't even taken their personal items. I can understand that of a man like Jeffreys, but it was most unusual for a lady such as Miss Veronica. So the idea came to me that perhaps they hadn't truly left.
Well, the Grey Knights and cultists are found. The Grey Knights wouldn't come out for just one cultist. Just send the guard. Send the guard for cleanup duty.
Right, Richards.
I learned that Mr. Richards had been seized by the local authorities. It seemed he was under suspicion for the murder of the missing lovers. This was too incredible. And then there's another odd thing that weighs on my mind. When we finally returned to England, Mr. Richards asked me to do him a small personal service. What was strange was that he insisted I keep the matter confidential and not breathe a word of it to anyone.
What kind of service?
Well, there's a small room with an iron door located above the backstage. It was used to store the stage lights and fireworks. He asked me to help him move all of Miss Veronica's personal belongings to the room. Every little thing, without exception. Her large trunk, her dresses, all of it.
You want to know what's even more, disconcerting and disturbing about this guy? He's got the best voice acting of the whole game so far. Like, that delivery is good. The sound quality is amazing. How has this one guy got the best voice acting in the game? Better than the protagonists. What the fuck? Even Lestrade sounds like he's forcibly reading lines that have been written for him whilst he's on his lunch break. Now this man whispers darker secrets to a man he just met. Sure, it's Holmes, but still, yeah, Holmes with 5 guineas.
Where is this room?
The end of the passage, but there is one difficulty. You see, Mr. Richards has the only key to the room's iron door, because only he has a complete set of keys to this building.
Goodbye, my friend.
My respects, my lord.
That's a goodbye, my friends, in the subtitle. So now we go back and talk to Mr. Richards and get the thing there. I've used a microphone. Yeah, that would probably indicate that he's the only professional voice actor out of everyone here.
Leave me alone, I have to work.
But... so he said there's a difficulty. Mr. Richards has the only key. Mr. Richards won't talk to me anymore. Please don't let me have softlocked the game by going for one or first. That actually is Mystery of the Druids level broken, if that's what's happened.
Closed.
How can you tell from there, Holmes? It won't even let me walk up there. It actually won't even let me walk up the stairs.
Closed.
He specifically goes to that bit there to say it's closed. What the fuck? Gin. That's a... blood. Blood. Gin. Closed. And some armor.
Would you like anything else, my lord?
Goodbye, my friend.
It says again, goodbye, my friends. I just... maybe talk to Mr. Kirby? Or maybe now I can talk to Mr. Richards because I tried the door and got closed.
Leave me alone.
I can't talk to Mr. Richards again. Okay. Why does he turn away from the door? Why am I in charge of Watson again?
Maybe Watson can go talk to Mr. Richards.
yourself? No, because as soon as I leave here, I get control of Sherlock back. Oh, here we go. We've got the thing from here. This road is the only sure way to reach Guacayamo, the town of parrots. Indeed, the branch of the Amazon where the town is situated is impassable due to the rapids. Many explorers have capsized there and were likely eaten by piranhas, as their bodies were never found. Even the native Indians from the nearby jungle refused to try these rapids. Instead, they employ their sturdy boats for sedentary fishing. Their ancestral mode of fishing is quite original. They use primitive spears to harpoon big fish while they watch for their dugouts. They conduct elaborate ceremonies to invoke the power of their gods before fish hunting and have much success with it. I don't know whether these gods exist, but these savages are inconsistent, incontestable archers. You should look after yourself so as not to offend them if you wish to negotiate with them. Certain tribal members are more sociable than the rest. They are agreeable to offer tobacco, some weapon, or incredible handmade objects in trade. These magnificent crafted items are often adorned with splendid green parrot feathers in honor of the conquistadors who named this town. You can also acquire leather goods made from the silky skin of the arboreal monkeys, which are hunted in this region. This leather is comparable to the touch of the fire silk and is unique in all the world. Unfortunately, as in many other cases, there are those unscrupulous people who manage to give the taste of alcohol to these naive populations. This poses a substantial threat to these small tribes and their future. There is also the steady arrival of gold prospectors and adventurers who have chopped down their forests and made the Indians more aggressive. Some of my guides have clearly suggested this primitive but picturesque culture will one day end in a bloody bath. End in a bloody bath. Blood bath. Blood bath, not bloody bath. Means it's demanding updates from nowhere near waking up to go reopening everything back up again. Weird.
I need more information.
The only updates I've been getting is Firefox wants an update. Even though it said it's going to reopen all my tabs, I never trust it to. Beckham has agreed. Can I talk to her anymore? Burgers!
Cannot take her earring.
Why would you cry? Maybe Mr. Kirby has the other key? Because, you know, he seems to be like an owner of sorts.
Do you have any other questions?
God, that audio quality.
I will see you later, Kirby.
Yes, it was good seeing you again.
Oh, I missed something then. God, why was that even an option? Yeah, I don't even know. Sherlock's just, you know, going around committing larceny now, apparently.
It's a little theft among friends.
Sherlock has friends? That's singular. Let's try the magic knife. Nope, the magic knife doesn't even do it. I genuinely don't know. So I'm going to consult the guide because it's getting late and what the fuck is even this? He has a Watson, at least. Whether or not Watson counts as a friend or not is a bit his, you know. Assume everything inside the box and click by make home decide to show a hint. So we need to be able to things in the prepare costume rooms. Get the whole thing outside. Talk for the expectation. Even in the guide, why the action changes to Watson here, I'm not sure. Okay, of course. Okay, yeah, okay. What? Why does he still have the knife? Because the knife works on everything. Including a loose stone in the wall. So I was on the right track of, you know, talking to someone else who seemed like an owner and might, you know, have the key. I was just talking to the wrong person. This is the guy.
She's fabulous, isn't she?
Do you have a complete set of keys to the theatre?
Oh, yes. Take them. But you will see to their safe return.
Doesn't even question it. Just says,
goodbye,
yeah, here you go.
Man.
Goodbye, sir.
Why him, though? So, his father used to own the theatre, and now he owns it instead. That's the reason. He just lost. He does, and he's just gazing at the people.
Stay there and inform me if Richards arrives.
All right, Holmes.
How, though?
Let us see whether we can find other evidence. I have no interest in this. A gift from the gods. I need something. Nice pattern made of encrusted nacre. What does it mean? This lock has never been forced. That is of no use to me. Nothing of any interest here. Closed. Watson, stay there.
Ooh. It lets me leave here.
No interest in this.
Why did it get removed, though? Why does he pick it up as if there's supposed to be something behind it and then just puts it right back afterwards? It is something about this.
Open the safe, I must have the two other earrings.
So now I need to go and get the earring from the woman. That's why Sherlock said that he wouldn't be able to get the earring from her. What the fuck? I don't know, Watson's there now, just stood there. These actors.
These actors.
I can. Yeah. So apparently I need to do something to take her earring. Maybe I tell the woman out here that she has the wig? Wait, which one had the which one wanted the wig?
What else do you want?
I love the knife is your first choice.
We must continue our investigation.
Of course.
It's fine, this will only hurt for a second. Chop.
I should show her one of my hints.
My stars.
Would you mind lending me your earring? I shall give it back to you in a few moments.
Certainly. Maybe you would like to borrow Doris's earring as well. I don't believe she would give it to you, but to me, certainly. If you wait here, I will get it for you.
Okay, cool. Just give me all three earrings. I didn't even know there was more than one. Oh my god. I've just seen the item descriptions. Silver earring. Silver earring. The silver earring! Exclamation mark.
When you're supposed to use.
Well, it's that one and maybe one of the other two. What the fuck? I don't get this. I mean, at this part of it at least is traditional point and click logic. So that one I can get behind, sort of. But still, what the fuck? It still would have been, better if they let me use
Once
the knife.
You
just
stay
go
there and
chop.
Inform me if Richards arrives.
Just go up to the other one. And was like, oh, I like your earring as well. Chop. Why the glitch frame there? Okay, so you go there. You go there? No, you go there.
It is elementary.
It is elementary.
Descriptions of exotic landscapes. Nothing of interest. Richards and Miss Davenport standing in front of the old Fairfax Theatre. But who is this third man?
Well, well, gentlemen, you arrive at precisely the right moment.
Is your good mood a sign that you have found something of interest?
Absolutely,
Holmes. We arrived. We've been here the whole time.
What? Really? We learned about it only by chance. It appears that at 1 o'clock this morning, Grimble arranged for his solicitors to send his demands to the court for the appropriation of Bromsby Enterprises. My men will spare nothing in their search for the elusive Grimble.
Lestrade, pray continue.
Then I followed your advice to move us further into our investigation of Mr. Richards. Did you know that his true name is Gaetano Riccardino? As this, Mr. Riccardino, at age 19, he was sentenced to 2 years imprisonment for armed robbery of a fair store. And who would you think the complainant was in this case? In truth, a certain Melvin Bromsby. This new evidence of his criminal past makes him another principal suspect in these murders.
Very interesting. Any other findings?
It would seem that Grimble and Richards are old associates. They were both intimately involved in the sale and transfer of the Fairfax Theatre. These two make quite a pair, don't you agree?
Well, Lestrade, I'll keep my thoughts on these matters secret for the moment.
Bah, you're not playing according to Hoyle. Really, Holmes, you must at least tell me your opinions on Richards.
Mr. Richards is an intelligent person. He is a man of great personal resources. If I had the power of Scotland Yard at my disposal, I would take all
by steps
necessary
in the box, so I know, right?
To ensure that Mr. Richards
what about
is
all the exotic locations?
Like,
I don't care.
And the sooner the better for
and
all
the two
concerned.
Royal documents that just
when the case
apparently
involves
aren't
murder,
nothing.
It is not wise to underestimate any possibilities.
You are a good man, Holmes. I swear upon my name that within the space of an hour, our friend Mr. Richards will be warming a cold cell at Dartmoor.
Very well, my friend. By the way, I would like to see you tomorrow at Sherringford Hall to discuss in greater detail some of the more puzzling elements of this case. Can I expect you?
I would not miss it for the world. This is most fortuitous, as Miss Bromsby also invited me to the hall. I was told they had good news to share, and it seems to me an engagement announcement must be at hand.
So, we shall see you tomorrow. Let us return to Baker Street.
Well, is Lestrade right?
This case does seem resolved.
There is but one piece missing that I need to complete this puzzle. Oh, it's not very important from the criminal point of view, but from the economic aspects of this case, it is essential. Regarding the question of whether Lestrade is correct, I will give you two items that should provide the answer that you seek. The first is a table representing the shoe sizes of the main characters in this case. Examine it carefully, Watson.
Oh, God!
A parcel for you, Mr. Holmes.
Ah, this would be Mycroft. Here is the final piece, which completes our puzzle, Watson.
Would this be the second element?
What second element?
You have just said that in order to determine if Lestrade is correct,
briefly.
I would need to consider two items. You told me about the shoe sizes, and I ask if this news article is the second clue.
Oh, no account. The second clue is a question, a very simple question. The answer will take the grass under the feet of several English citizens, for if they cannot even guess the answer to this question, they are for the gallows. The question is as follows. Watson.
Oh, this is that damn silent zombie. Yeah.
Slept with a cushion. It seems to me that
there are precisely two child models in this game, and they both look awful because they're nowhere else.
The question should be answered yes or no and justified by the evidence or testimony received during the investigation.
Are there several sets of keys from the Aston Theatre? Yes. Because didn't... No, wasn't it? Bruce. I mean, yes, there are. Undercranial point click adventure game, right? It's a pixel hunt one, that's the problem. Did one of the actresses lose a red-haired wig? Yes. Yes, you. Could discovering the dressing room be connected to the case? Yes. No, it's not that one. Dressing. There's a costume register with 30 listed. It means everyone is missing from the uniform. And right at the beginning... There. Artillery uniform. Could the writing on the message to Veronica Davenport be found elsewhere? Early morning, the lifeless body of Mr. Raymond Waters, a well-known engineer, was found online in the Market District. At an early point in the investigation, it was found that a brawl was the cause of an unfortunate demise. Date of funeral service has not been announced. To Veronica. I misread that. I misread. Somehow my brain combined limes and drama and got mysterious llama in London. To Victoria. Llama Phone Fox was here. Yeah. It says yes, but I don't know what. Oh, we only got those four. Okay. Those are it, because those are the same, aren't they? So this is the one I'm tripped up on slightly. Are there several sets of keys from the Aston Theatre? Yes, because... Oh, yeah, retaining several keys. Well, I don't understand the purpose of your questions, but yes, there were indeed two keys for the Fairfax Theatre. I should be able to get every one of them.
We must have made an error. The question should be answered.
Fine. I'm going to get through this quiz system because it's wonky as all hell. Right, okay. Right, are there? Yes. And testimony says you were first in conversation. Oh, it's Bruce. Bruce's thing was the thing that said it? Okay, sure. Well, the actress says the word hey, good. Yes, Miss Sullivan. Yep. Could be yes. Shame for all. Discovery of fake artillery boss in the kitchen. Yep. And the evidence on the could be like on the message revealing to the point, yes. Well, I got everything else right.
It is simplicity itself, Watson. We have answered all the questions.
Congratulations, you have successfully completed your investigation. The following answers are questions are optional, you do not have to answer them to correctly reach the last step of the game. Oh, who killed Sir Bromsby? Who killed Horace Fowlett? Who killed Johansson? Who killed Veronica Davenport? Who killed Jeffreys? Who killed Hunter? You did not answer correctly. Do you want to proceed to the final movie anyway? I think he's the killer. At least for Bromsby, I think he's the killer. Because there was a lot of stuff like with red hair and with grease on it, and he's the only person there who fits that same description. As for the rest of these, I don't know. I honestly thought I was going to be solving only one murder. So, let's get the guide up again. And see what this is. Who killed Horace Fowler? Collins? Who killed Johansson? Jeffreys. Nobody is an option. Jeffreys isn't even listed here. Who killed Jeffreys? Well, nobody killed Jeffreys. Who killed Hunter? Harrington. Okay, so where's Jeffreys then? There isn't a Jeffreys thing. What the fuck? Okay, so the guide says it's Jeffreys, but I don't have Jeffreys as an option for whatever reason. Okay. Sure. Final movie.
Cabby!
I don't think we can, that's the problem. Yeah, the game doesn't let you. Like, if you've missed something, it doesn't let you continue.
Mr. Holmes, Dr. Watson, I feel relieved that everything is settled. The inspector told me that you were not as useful as you had hoped in this case, but you did your best, and I am grateful to you.
Just look with the other two.
Dear Lestrade, well, the inspector deliberately minimized my role in this matter so that I could reveal a secret to you.
I wish James, I mean, Lieutenant Harrington, could be here now, but...
He had to leave for London on a very urgent business.
But how could you know?
It is my business to know, Miss Bromsby. Thus, I am able to tell you about the case of the silver earring. Everything begins on that sad afternoon, which was to celebrate your birthday, and ended with the untimely death of your father. Miss Bromsby, you did not murder your father. I kissed your hand that day and did not detect even the slightest smell of gunpowder. I also discovered powder traces that proved the shot was fired from behind the second side door. You were not seen at that door, but where did the murderer go after taking his shot? Everyone who tried to exit through the side entrance found it blocked. According to witnesses and other evidence, none of the guests could have possibly been the murderer because they were all present in the ballroom. No one left through the service door, and traces confirm that no one could have fled by using the staircase. The windows in the kitchen, as elsewhere in the manor, were appointed with thick bars, thus they offered no escape. So did he vanish into thin air? In fact, one of the parties did leave the ballroom and went to the kitchen corridor.
From what is...
He left to meet his accomplice, who was not an invited guest. This accomplice was a professional actor who was disguised to resemble our missing invitee. This guest hid under voile in the shadow of a statue and waited for his moment. Meanwhile, his twin acted out his part in the ballroom and provided the murderer with a perfect alibi. When the killer heard the applause, he left his hiding place, aimed, took his shot, and hit his target. It is important to know that the actor was well placed at the manor. He secured entry to the manor by impersonating a French head waiter. Using his position, he persuaded those in charge to use long tableclothes and to arrange the tables in a most peculiar manner. When the shooting occurred, our actor joined the crowd and rapidly crept across the room, concealed under the tables. As he neared the side door, he rose from beneath the last table and acted as if he had been jostled and fallen. However, as he stood, he accidentally snagged a small piece of his dirty glove upon a chair. When he arrived at the door, which was held closed by the murderer, he tapped on it using a prearranged code and was allowed entry. He exited to the corridor while his partner continued to hold the door shut against all others. The actor discarded his disguise in the deep kitchen well, helped himself to two bottles of excellent whiskey, and quietly went outside. The assassin waited several minutes. Then, in the last seconds of the confusion, he returned to the ballroom. Thus, we have the crime committed by an individual whom everyone swears was in the room when the shot was fired.
But this agrees with my conclusions. Richard is an actor, and everyone swears that Grimble was in the room. I didn't consider the course of events as you described, Holmes, but admit it, our deductions agree. Moreover, both of these suspects are similar in size and manner.
Your theory presumes that Grimble is an excellent shot, which is false. It also takes on faith that Sir Bromsby had discovered the misappropriations, supplying Grimble his motive, but irrefutable proof that neither Grimble nor Richard were guilty waited at Horace Fowlett's.
The matter of his
pillow.
But there was no pillow at Horace Fowlett's.
Nevertheless, Mr. Fowlett slept with one. When I arrived at his home, I believed him already dead. Therefore, the news of his hasty departure came as no surprise. From the evidence obtained at his home and the statements of his neighbour, I learned the following. On the evening of his death, Mr. Fowlett was visited by a man who desired to sell him some exotic trifle. While this man distracted Mr. Fowlett, a second man quietly crept into the house and tried to open his safe. This individual was well acquainted with the house and the location of the safe. but when he failed to open it, he most likely became enraged and killed Mr. Fowlett. This individual, Miss Bromsby, was your cousin, Wyatt Collins, who returned to England under the name Johansson.
But what about this pillow?
Mr. Fowlett's pillow had vanished. Later, Dr. Watson discovered a feather from the pillow in the train compartment used by the man who impersonated Fowlett. But why did Fowlett's impersonator take the pillow, and why didn't the station manager notice it? Mr. Fowlett was short, but very portly. In order to imitate him, the man used the pillow to create the appearance of a stouter man. There is no other explanation. This man was a much leaner man than Mr. Fowlett, Mr. Grimble, or Mr. Richards.
Then, Holmes, who did murder Sir Bromsby? And for what reason?
You see, Lestrade, when it's a question of multiple murders, except for the deviant ones, there are two primary motives, revenge and greed. Wyatt Collins' presence at Fowlett's tells us his motive was about Bromsby's wealth. He went there for the express purpose of stealing the will so that he would receive at least a portion of Bromsby's estate. If his uncle had died with no will found, Collins would have been entitled to a share of the inheritance under English law.
But if my cousin failed in his attempt and the evidence clears my name, though I am to inherit, why were my father and cousin murdered? Besides, tomorrow I am to announce my engagement and will be married soon.
Holmes, hold on. There is a flaw in your reasoning. There is only one key for the door to the cement factory, and Grimble is the only person known to have it. So he must be directly involved in the murder of Johansson. I mean Collins.
Is that true, Lestrade? Mr. Richards told me that there was indeed a second key, which was lost. And have you forgotten the murder of the Barman Hunter? A young man without any criminal record, whose sole interests were painting and flowers. Why was he murdered in cold blood,
even
with
that
no signs of forceful entry or theft at his lodgings? Simply put,
even that
he was
animation
killed
was
because
glitched.
He was present when your father was
this
murdered.
This is a cutscene that's got glitches in it.
What did he see or hear? And above all, how did he acquire the earring of Miss Veronica Davenport, the leading actress of the Fairfax Theatre and Dwight Richards' mistress?
I can stand this no more. My thoughts are dazed. Will you finally reveal who murdered my father?
The murderer? Here he comes now. I understand your feelings of incredulity, but I have never been more serious. You must know that the first person who enters this room is the murderer of your father, Miss Bromsby, and I will provide irrefutable proof of their guilt.
Well, good afternoon, gentlemen. You made the right choice to leave London. It is unbearably foggy. But Lavinia, darling, what's going on?
She knows.
But how?
Why has it gone back into this rolling scene with a cutscene?
I don't understand. Whatever do you mean?
Oh no, you understand me clearly, Mr. Harrington.
He is now no longer sitting on that chair.
Or should I say, Mr. Jeffries?
Explain yourself, Mr. Holmes. What a monstrous misunderstanding.
Oh, I've just explained myself to Miss Bromsby about the truth of her father's murder, but I can tell the story again from the very beginning. It begins several years ago. Wyatt Collins, the nephew of Mr. Bromsby, is forced by his uncle to leave England for South America. His hatred is fostered by the ingratitude he perceives in Sir Bromsby. Wasn't his uncle
the maid walked in instead? Ah, yes,
in
mistress comes, stain cleaner.
Bromsby owes him an eternal debt of gratitude, and was thus obliged to finance Collins' indolent lifestyle, fulfilling his.
I killed him. I was glad to do it. Cleaning up those goddamn cum stains made me have nightmares.
Then we have you, Mr. Harrington. You were a brilliant student at the Military Academy, and are an excellent shot, are you not? You were the only person at the reception with sufficient skills to make the shot that took Sir Bromsby's life. During my investigation, I learned that ex-officers of Her Majesty's Army enjoy great favour around the world for administrative positions. You left India and made your way to Brazil, where you obtained the position as warden of the prison in Guaquiamo. Do not try to deny your presence there. The pictures in your hunting portfolio could have been taken nowhere else in the world except Guaquiamo. We now have our second criminal, Lieutenant Harrington. Mr. Jeffries, your arrival in Guaquiamo set things in motion. The theatre company had come to Brazil as part of their worldwide tour. You had been involved with the lovely Veronica Davenport and loved her with a passionate yet possessive love. However, Miss Davenport did not share your affections. She had, in fact, tried several times to end your affair prior to the company's arrival in Guacamayo. It seems she was truly devoted to Dwight Richards and would never leave him. After you arrived, you frequented the town's bawdier spots. This is where you first met Mr. Harrington, and you quickly became close companions. It seems tedium and heartbreak do bring certain people together. After the performance,
by
alcohol and grief, you killed Miss Davenport.
Did partially think he was just going to raise his arms to go.
You then fled to your newfound friend, the warden, to confess your crime and beg for his help. In a show of friendship, he helped dispose of her corpse and directed suspicions towards your rival, Dwight Richards. Afterwards, you lay low, leaving the others to believe that you had been killed or had gone missing. You stayed hidden until they had departed, and you must have kept Miss Davenport's earring as some morbid souvenir. No doubt you also retained not only the key to the Fairfax Theatre, but the keys from Aston's, where you had been employed several years earlier. Here, then, is our third felon, Mr. Jeffries. Life was difficult in Brazil for our trio. Mr. Jeffries rarely went out, Mr. Harrington's men were talking behind his back, and Mr. Collins' funds were inadequate. One evening, Collins spoke of his cousin, who, in a few months' time, was to return to England from finishing school. She was also the sole heir to one of the greatest fortunes in England. Imagine these three men besotted with alcohol, considering the wealth that would one day pass to this slip of a girl. A terrible plan was devised. Several days later, they left for England, false papers for two of their party in hand, resolved to seize a portion, if not all, of this great inheritance.
Incredible!
Yes, incredible.
Scene.
And horribly true. At first, their plan was to forge a duplicate will or destroy the original so that Mr. Collins would receive a share of the estate. This would happen soon enough, as they would murder Sir Bromsby at his daughter's birthday reception. It was essential that Collins enter the country under false papers, so that neither his uncle nor the authorities would be alerted to his presence in England. This would avoid any suspicion attaching him for his uncle's death when he arrived to claim his inheritance. They quickly put their plans into effect. Mr. Jeffries arrived at the household in the guise of a stylish French head waiter and studied the lay of the manor. Mr. Harrington, the assassin, would accompany a person with rather poor eyesight to the reception so that the illusion of the fake Mr. Harrington would go unchallenged. As the head waiter, Jeffries was in a unique position to study the guest list. He quickly learned that two of the guests, Miss Rowntree and Colonel Patterson, had both poor eyesight and were unaccompanied. Lieutenant Harrington was quite busy in the days before the reception.
He
courted Miss Rowntree with great dedication and made fast friends with the Colonel. He hoped to secure one, if not two, invitations to the reception. Your arrival as the Colonel's guest was your first error, Harrington. Is it credible that a young officer who left the army because of his hatred towards all military authority would easily befriend a man who embodies everything that he detests? But your efforts bore fruit, and you obtained your invitation. Mr. Jeffries, as head waiter, took great care that the tables and tableclothes were arranged specifically to accommodate their schemes. Mr. Jeffries then secured the disguise for his role as the false Lieutenant Harrington. He remembered that an officer's uniform, similar to Lieutenant Harrington's, and a red wig, identical to the colouring of the lieutenant's hair, were in storage at the Fairfax Theatre. He learned that the company
that
had taken up residence at the site of the old Aston Theatre, for which he still had the key.
What the hell?
It was therefore a simple matter for him to acquire these items for his masquerade.
Fuck.
They now only lacked the will, which Mr. Collins presumed was kept at Flowlet's house. Their plan was to take these papers prior to the murder of Sir Bromsby, so that Flowlet would be unaware of either their presence or a substitution until it was too late. But things went badly. Mr. Jeffries tried to divert Mr. Flowlet, but he must have been alerted by some noise, as Collins struggled vainly to open the safe. Upon being discovered, Collins killed Flowlet on the spot. The two conspirators then left the house in such a way that witnesses believed it was Fowler himself who had left.
There's not room for him. It's really not.
Way to get hold of the money.
Nothing about Jeffreys is human here.
Had disinherited Collins in favor of his daughter. They decided to take the money from his daughter, a young, naive and vulnerable young woman. On the day of reception, Mr. Harrington arrived with Jeffreys, disguised as his servant Spencer and the colonel. With the promise of whiskey, Jeffreys easily secured the unwitting aid of two fellow servants and assumed
so he was
position
there the whole
the
time.
Door.
And I spoke to him, yet it didn't let him have
three good bottles of liquor
from
the kitchen.
It had a different name for
his
him.
Companions would cover for
fuck's sake.
Him. I have just explained what happened next. After the shooting, he took two bottles of excellent whiskey. Only someone knowledgeable would have taken these two bottles over the others, and Mr. Jeffreys had been formerly employed at a luxurious hotel in France. Upon his return,
he gave an accounting to his
fellow servants, did his hair, and left the manor.
I don't have the technology to do that.
And his frightened look secured the two men's cooperation in providing his alibi. They could not have known his true role in these events. The one problem for the conspirators was the barman, Simon Hunter. He had perfect eyesight, unlike the colonel, and realized that the man who claimed to be near the bar at the time of the murder had in fact lied. He hinted as much to Mr. Harrington and most certainly intended blackmail. As they were short on funds, the accomplices gave him Miss Davenport's earring as collateral and pledged to return with the money he demanded. That night, when Lieutenant Harrington visited us in London, he had just come from Simon Hunter's. Hunter had told Harrington that the earring had been pawned and he would not reveal the name of the shop unless Harrington paid him his money. Mr. Harrington ruthlessly killed Hunter, and the earring so precious to Mr. Jeffreys was lost. Earlier that morning, Jeffreys lured Collins to the cement factory on the pretext of fabricating false evidence against Grimble. But they no longer needed Collins to acquire the Bromsby fortune. Mr. Harrington would wed the young heiress, then, after a reasonable time, they would cause her untimely death, and they would take it all. So Mr. Jeffreys murdered Collins and made sure his body was barely recognizable. If he was identified, it would not affect their plans, as they believed leaving the corpse at the cement factory would direct suspicion towards Grimble. When Mr. Harrington came to see us, he learned we were hot on Collins' trail and had traced his movements up to the factory. He assumed we would go there within the hour and left to quickly round up his associates and devise a plan. Jeffreys, from his days at the Fairfax Theatre, knew an Asian of questionable talents who had no visible ties with this case and could attack us without drawing suspicion their way. We avoided this attack, and from that moment, I was convinced of Lieutenant Harrington's involvement in the conspiracy. The last elements of proof were revealed at the vagrant's camp near the monastery outside of London. Mr. Jeffreys had tramped through England in his past and might have thought to hide Collins in the forest near the Richmond's Abbey. The very day that I was there, he tried to destroy all evidence of Collins' murder. Fortunately, he did not manage to destroy everything. It seems Collins, foreseeing his possible death, left a small surprise for his accomplices. It would be easily missed, except by someone who observes all and misses nothing.
But this is merely some draft to lull us to sleep, Mr. Holmes. Lavinia, surely you can't believe these mad accusations. They arise from nothing. What proof do you offer for what you say? None.
Believe what you will, Mr. Harrington. I will warn you that Mr. Collins left a letter written in his own hand, which named yourself and Mr. Jeffreys and accused you both of complicity in the murder of his uncle. At this very moment, Inspector Lestrade's men are conducting a search of your rooms. They will find the evidence that, when added to the accusations within this letter, will prove your guilt beyond all doubt. The Chiripaque cigarettes, your portfolio, as well as a feather from the pillow which was taken from Horace Fowlett's, these items prove my deductions. I suggest we wait here for their arrival with these proofs, and I assure you our wait will be brief.
Shh! It's 130 years ago, you're not at work.
Accept my apologies, my dear Lavinia. I think under the circumstances it would be best if we postponed our engagement. I'm sorry for your father, but what do you expect? We had to give it our best shot.
Where is the earring now? You will tell me, where is it? Unless you tell me at once where the earring is, no one will leave this room alive. Don't you understand? You are all going to die.
Ha ha! What the fuck
they
is
all
that?
Yours, Lestrade. I suggest you return with your agents to London as soon as possible.
He's not even got his finger in the trigger guard. Oh my god, he's
Watson,
just holding the handle.
Let us escort Miss Bromsby to her rooms. She will need her wrist.
Holmes, Collins never.
Yeah, but there's too much guns and violence here for you.
Jeffers.
Get the fuck out. Yeet.
Indeed, Watson. But they could not have known. I played my bluff.
Oh no, it's a cutscene gun.
And Grimble, where did he appear from?
You can now boast that one of the most influential men in England served as your driver. Since my visit to Valence, I knew that Grimble had nothing to do with this crime. I asked him to assist with the investigation, and it was at my request that he took steps to acquire Bromsby Enterprises. He gained us precious time by forcing Harrington and Jeffries to wait and see if Miss Bromsby would inherit. He ran quite a risk in doing me this favor, because their plot then turned against him. I also asked him to send the letter which lured the two murderers away from the hall. I needed a moment to explain everything to Miss Lavinia. It would be dreadful if she fell into the hands of her father's killer. From the beginning, Grimble was concerned only with saving her inheritance. He never once doubted her innocence.
Nevertheless, didn't he misappropriate those funds?
Indeed, but not for his own profit. It was solely to protect his friend Bromsby. An ex-architect with whom he had quarrelled, a Mr. Waters, had contacted Sir Bromsby before this intrigue began. Waters learned from Captain Bowie that Sir Bromsby had encouraged certain actions against workers hired to build a bridge in India. That project was the bridge over the Kalidasa Abyss. Waters blackmails Bromsby.
I've just realised they cannot decide whether there's one or two S's in Kalidasa.
He knew his hot-tempered friend well.
Some places say one S and others say two. What the fuck?
Disastrous consequences. So Grimble
I don't even know anymore.
To Waters in exchange for his silence. Unfortunately, Collins discovered the arrangement while he was working at the cement factory and threatened to reveal everything. Grimble could not afford for that to occur. He managed to rid himself of Collins by sending him to Fowlett. Then it was Bromsby's turn to discover the blackmail by sheer accident. He was angered, but before he could decide his next move, Mr. Waters died suddenly and removed all threat. When Grimble learned that Waters had died, he confessed all to Bromsby. He noted that the money paid was a pittance when measured against Bromsby Enterprises, and that the same amount could now be applied in other ways. India had enriched them so greatly, and Bromsby had been cursed over the harm done to the Indian people in his employment. It was decided that these same funds would now be sent on a monthly basis to a Bombay orphanage in the care of a Sergeant Brahmai. It is possible that Bromsby intended to increase his patronage, and this was the important news he intended to reveal to the press at his daughter's reception. It was she who had harshly reproached him regarding his behavior towards the Indians in his employ. Do you remember the words from that poem which he had written into his notes? It said that the ungrateful always die miserably.
Indeed, Holmes. But there is one thing that I still don't understand. Why did you ask Lestrade to put Richards behind bars? He wasn't guilty of any crime, but you treated him as a murderer.
I advised Lestrade that it would be prudent to place Richards in custody so we could protect him from harm. Mr. Richards is a wise and intelligent man. He would have recognized Harrington and Jeffries on sight. When he realized that Jeffries was alive and that I possessed the missing earring, he would have drawn the same conclusions as I. So this investigation would have been stopped cold by one or two more murders.
I see.
Well, Watson, you
seem to
know everything.
What the fuck is that delivery of that line?
Tell me, please, that small missive which I can see on the desk. It contains two invitations to the opera's opening night, does it not? If so, we shall finally have our opportunity.
There's just no quality in that camera movement of the cutscene. What the fuck? Based on a novel written by Julia Lamar, not actually an Arthur Conan Doyle one. just end? I mean, they did just give like a nearly 10-minute or more long conclusion of the entirety of the investigation. That was something. Yeah, that was, yeah, that's an accurate statement. That was something. That has got to be, without a shadow of a doubt, the jankiest, most broken, most messed up, most nonsensical game I have ever played in my life. I just... what the actual ever-living donkey fuck? I thought I'd seen really janky games. I really thought I'd seen janky games, but that has proved me wrong. And the best part is, this isn't the only janky game in the series. Like, so... I said before, I'm not going to be playing Sherlock Holmes, the Sherlock Holmes Awakened Remastered. Mostly because Frogwares went and remade the game and made it more canonically in keeping with Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1, because I'm going to be playing that. However, as I said, I think I said like last week, at the end of this series, I'm going to play that original one because I do have it. And that is apparently even more broken, including Watson teleporting. Like... not even like, you know, you go from one room and he's there, another room, he's there. No, you are looking at him, you turn around and he's there in front of you again. I don't even know. I just... wow. However, as janky as it was and how most of the quizzes... well, actually, no, one of the quizzes did not make sense because the evidence it wanted actually contradicted the conclusion that it gave. And aside from the frustrations of it, that was well written. And that is either Frogware's very first game, or it's just their first Sherlock game, or maybe it's both. And anyone who has seen any later on Frogwares games, like Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1, The Sinking City, etc., knows that, yeah, they're not amazing game developers, but they are fantastic story writers, and this shows that even in their early games, they still had that spark. They really did. And joke the game, I cannot. I really can't. I mean, answering for an unjoke, all I can say is, knock, knock. Who's there? UPS. Delivery for you. Anything I've seen that might be janky is Madagascar 2 on PC. Sorry, PS2. I don't think I ever saw Madagascar. I'm not going to do Kitty screen time. He's right behind you, Callie.
Not the baby.
No.
Why not?
You went calling him, and then when he started yowling, you didn't go...
I wasn't...
yeah, after calling him. You know what he's like with closed doors.
I didn't know
what. Oh. Here we get teleported. Watson, why can't we get teleporting Watsons? I mean, technically we did in Sherlock Holmes Chapter 1. Like, the John in that was not technically John Watson, but he was... he was there. Okay, yeah, so, yeah, looking at the games developed, this is their third game developed, because there was Sherlock Holmes Mystery of the Mummy, which got ported to the DS. But... as everything I've seen, it was more of a hidden objects game rather than an actual proper point and click game. So, yeah, and then they made Journey to the Center of the Earth, so... But yeah. So, that is where I'm going to be ending things tonight. Slightly early because that's finished and I'm not going to be going on onto the next game. Yes, yeah, they ported the mummy one to the DS, and weirdly enough, they ported this one, Secret of the Silver Ring, to the Wii, and the Wii alone. I don't get that. That's a weird decision. However, next week, we are going to be starting on with the next one that I have in the series, with Sherlock Holmes versus Jack the Ripper. Now, this one I have played before, and I've completed on the Xbox 360 at least 10 years ago, most likely more. So I have forgotten a lot of it. And I've been informed by Callie that the PC version has jank, whereas the Xbox 360 version just didn't. The only thing the Xbox 360 version had was one of the puzzles didn't register properly. You had to do a very specific thing. Yeah. But yeah, that's the one we're going to be doing next. And it was the first Frogwares game that I had played, and I honestly really enjoyed it. Like, I really enjoyed the narrative, and I promise you the narrative is a massive step up from this, because this was a very much, there is only one conclusion that can be drawn. Only one. And it plays it out for you, whether you get the answers right at the end or not. What they did with Jack the Ripper and then onwards was they presented you with, here's a list of suspects. You use the evidence you've gathered and the conclusions you've drawn to determine who you think is guilty. And the game goes ahead with that. It's very, very good. It's very well written. It's very good. I really do like the way they've done it. So yeah, that's going to be starting next week. Yes, what? The Wii? Yeah. I don't know why they put this on the Wii and just nowhere else. I don't know. Do you ever get the chance to play the Tintin games, the new one coming to PC? I have no interest in Tintin. Tintin arrived when I was in my phase of, if I'm going to be watching a cartoon, it needs to be fun, and Tintin was too realistic and heavy in the content. I was just like, no. Then again, I was also the kid that didn't like Rupert. Rupert the Bear. Like, my brain was just like, no, too serious. Too non-cartoony. So, yeah, I'd never got into it. But yeah, so next week we are going to be going on with Sherlock Holmes versus Jack the Ripper. I definitely do have that installed, don't I? Yes, Sherlock Holmes versus Jack the Ripper is installed. And it's better. Like, it is a lot better than this one was. So yeah, looking forward to that. However, for tonight, that is all I'm going to be doing tonight, because it's like less than 10 minutes. Yeah, so thank you all very much for coming along, for all your support. It's all greatly appreciated in whatever way you chose to show it. Next stream from me is going to be tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. EST, which is 4 p.m. BST, where I'm going to be continuing my adventures in Final Fantasy XIV. And then directly after that, we'll be raiding into Lydia's stream, and she and I will be playing co-op Last Hero of Nostal Gaia and finishing off the DLC. Well, we found the second area of DLC, and after that, well, it depends on how long it takes us to clear it. We might do it in one session, we might do it in two, who knows. And then there'll be an hour's break, and then I will be on Jace's stream with also Q, doing more Outriders, and we're getting very close to the end of that as well. And then I'm going to be throwing them both through hell, going through an expedition. I'm evil. But yeah. So that is everything. So yeah, thank you all again for coming along and for your support. Until next time, have yourselves a good rest of your day, a good night, a good evening, a good afternoon, or a good morning. Until next time though, stay safe, stay amazing, and see you later. Bye!